Now listen here. If A cross B equal to 6, if n of A cross B equal to 6, n of means what? Cardinal number. Cardinal number. N of A cross B equal to 6. Cardinal number of A cross B. That means how many pairs are there in A cross B. Then, and A equal to 1 comma 2. Then, N of B is what? They have given 4 answers. 4 options are there. Which one is the correct? First, before doing the problem, first you can see to this note. If N of A equal to P and N of B equal to Q, then N of A cross B equal to P into Q. That means what? N of A cross B equal to N of A into N of B. N of A cross B, N of A is what? P. N of B is what? Q. Therefore, N of A cross B is P into Q. Since we are using the variable, we are not putting into sign. Just you can write PQ. Similar way, here you have to do. What is given actually? N of A cross B equal to 6. Isn't it? Next, we know already. What is it? N of A cross B is nothing but N of A into N of B. Do you follow? This is into here. Because N of A, now you want to substitute. But they have given only A. So, you have to find out the cardinal number. How can you find out the cardinal number? Number of elements in the given set is called cardinal number. Cardinal number is nothing but number of elements in a finite set. In a finite set. This is a finite set. You are able to count it. Countable number of elements are there. So, N of A equal to 2. What are they asking? N of B equal to. N of A cross B is 6 they have given. N of A, from this you found out. What is it? 2. Then N of B you have to find it out. Therefore, N of B equal to 6 divided by 2. 1, 2 is 2, 3, 2 are 6. So, N of B equal to 2. So, what is the answer here? This is the answer. Do we follow? This is the answer. But, this is one mark problem. Is it necessary to do all these steps? No. Actually, from this you can find it out directly. Very easily you can find it out. No need to do all these steps. If you know this concept, within a fraction of second you will be able to give the answer. Because here N of A is equal to 2. Here N of A cross B is equal to 6. That means what? 2 threes are 6. Otherwise 6 by 2 is 3. That's all. So, no need to do all these steps. But while you are learning, if it is in the beginning, now only if you are starting, you try to do the steps like this and also try to study the note what it is given in the book. Then after that, while you are revising, you try to do it like one word. Do you follow?